मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एज लेसन 8 हैज बीन कंप्लीटेड, सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 9. चैप्टर नंबर 9, द एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ कंपनी रूल इन इंडिया. दिस चैप्टर टेल्स यू द स्टोरी ऑफ एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ ब्रिटिश रूल इन इंडिया एंड हाउ दे स्टार्टेड देयर कंपनी और ट्रेड, मीन्स हाउ डिफरेंट कंट्रीज स्टार्टेड their company or trade in India and took advantages. For example, so many people from different countries like England, Spain, France, Holland, Portugal, etc. They came in India and tried to control over India, or they came to India for different purposes. And you know, the first European who came to India, do you know the name of this person? He was Vasco da Gama. The Vasco da Gama was the first European who came to India. Vasco da Gama was the Portuguese explorer. Vasco da Gama landed at Calicut in 1498. Calicut on the Malabar coast. So Vasco da Gama landed at Calicut in 1498, and that is the beginning of the European era in Indian history. European era in the Indian history. And in the 16th century, the Portuguese had established their colony in India. As I told you, that many European trading companies established their trading centers in coastal areas. They established their trading centers in coastal areas of India. So what were the name of these trading centers? That these trading centers were known as factories. Factories means the place where factors or officials worked. My dear students, you should keep in mind the meaning of factories. What do you mean by the factories? Factories means the place where factors or official works. And the trading posts which are located by the different countries were known as factories. Some of the factories were fortified as a safeguard from the rival trading companies. Fortified means provide with defensive work as protection against attack. As you know, so many companies from different countries came from Europe in India for the trading purposes, like France, Spain, England, and they all were rival trading companies. These trading company purchased so many things from India at very cheap rate, like spices, cotton, textile, indigo and saltpeter. Saltpeter means raw material for making gunpowder. So these trading companies purchased these items at very cheap rate and sold them in Europe and America at very high prices and got their huge profit. These huge profit margins led to competition among the foreign trading companies, because all the companies want more and more profit. Finally, the other trading companies had to bow out to the England, means countries, they were not able to face the competition with British and French. That's why they bowed to the England and French companies, who remained the main rivals in India. So who were the main rivals in India? They were France and England. Only two rival companies were there, France and England. Then the East India Company set up trading post in Surat. एंड थ्री प्रेसिडेंसी सेटलमेंट एट फोर्ट विलियम इन बंगाल, फोर्ट सेंट जॉर्ज इन मद्रास एंड बॉम्बे कैसल. माई डियर स्टूडेंट, यू हैव टू लर्न विच इज़ द फर्स्ट ट्रेडिंग पोस्ट सेटअप बाय द ईस्ट इंडियन कंपनी. दैट वॉज सूरत. एंड थ्री प्रेसिडेंसी सेटलमेंट्स वर फोर्ट विलियम इन बंगाल, सेकेंड फोर्ट सेंट जॉर्ज इन मद्रास एंड थर्ड बॉम्बे कैसल. Britishers establish friendly relation with the local princes to further their profit, because Britishers wanted more and more profit. So what they do, what they done, because wanted to enter in the areas or territories of local rulers, so British assured that they were the friends of them. The Indian rulers signed alliances. Alliances means agreement, or we can say treaties with Britishers. So Indian rulers signed alliances with Britishers to secure the help of the English military to settle their internal rivalries. As you know, the British military were very powerful, so the Indian rulers took help from the Britishers against their internal rivalries. British took advantages at their situation, and slowly the Indian princes became the puppets in the hands of the English. What do you mean by the puppets? Puppets means a person or wooden doll that is controlled by somebody else. Means the king became the puppets in the hand of Britishers. I think you have saw a puppet show also, and you are very familiar with puppets. So this is a question: how could a trading company became an imperial power? How could a trading company became an imperial power? The real answer is that the East India Company became an imperial power to protect its trading interest from other European traders. It began as a trading company, took over political control, and became the ruler of entire India. They tried to build up its own military and administrative departments. It became such a strong force, and it took over the governments of Bengal, Madras means now Chennai, and Bombay, now Mumbai. Gradually, the trading company transformed into an auxiliary government and military power that ended only in 1858. So I hope you understood that how this trading company became an imperial power in India. My dear students, in next topic we will discuss different wars. Like first war, the Carnatic Wars, we will discuss in next video. Thank you and have a nice day.